So pretty much ever since there's been indirect fire, such as artillery, even cannons, or even later on with airplanes and close air support, there's always been an issue with targeting. How does a soldier, a sailor, a Marine, someone on the ground, close to the combat, get munitions targeting from any kind of platform to where they need to get something destroyed? One of the newest solutions to that targeting problem for the Marine on the ground is the next generation handheld targeting system. This system is basically a way for Marines to get any munition from pretty much any platform to a target on the battlefield when they need it and where they need it, even if GPS has been denied or degraded. So in February, the Marine Corps awarded Northrop Grumman a $252 million contract to create such a device. They're expected to deliver that device under 10 pounds in about a year. So this new device is going to provide really three areas that the Marine Corps is going after. That's to increase situational awareness, basically knowing what's going on, have accurate coordination of fire, so if you have to have multiple platforms firing at different times or in sync, and also getting beyond line of sight. It has to go over the horizon or to an area where I might not be able to see, but I know there's something I need to hit. So this device is going to really bring in things from artillery, aircraft, loitering munitions, loitering drones, missile strikes or missile systems that are way away from the battlefield, have a far distance to reach the battlefield, and even ships offshore firing naval gunfire, other types of coordinated precision guidance systems. So in winning the contract, Northrop Grumman has really promised to provide rapid target acquisition, laser terminal guidance operation, later spot imaging, which basically means illuminating a surface with a laser, high definition infrared sensors with accuracy and grid capability over extended ranges, and high definition color display with day and night celestial compass. Celestial meaning stars, so basically you can navigate by the stars through the device if you can't get GPS. Now this isn't the first time that the Marines have had such a system. It hasn't always been maps and compasses and pencils and papers. I mean, that was the way it was done decades ago, but we've had high tech for a while. However, this device will replace four existing devices: the portable lightweight designated rangefinder, the joint terminal attack controller, the laser target designator, and the thermal laser spot imager. All those are coming out of Marine Corps Systems Command. So rather than maintaining, supplying, and delivering four different systems that are tailored to specific types of firing and targeting, one system will do it all. Not to be outdone, the Army has their own system that went through testing and evaluation in 2018 and 19 and began fielding in 2020. That system is known as the Joint Effects Targeting System, or JETS. Now JETS comes in a little bit under 17 pounds and has three major modules, so it's a little bit more to carry. It has a handheld target location module, a laser marking module, a precision azimuth vertical angle module, and a tripod mount for those different systems. While the Army has begun fielding its own JET systems a couple years ago, the Marines are starting to field that new prototype from Northrop Grumman next year, expecting to be fully fielded and fully completed across the Marine Corps by 2030. For Military Times, this is Todd South.